Get ready to match the stars from Carter Country, Richard Paul, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flynn as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, Johnny O. Thanks very much. I didn't have time to tie my shoes.
Sloppy.
Yes, now I need another shoe.
Well, if you'll hang on, I'll see if he's here.
Let me do it.
It's for you, Chief.
Thanks.
It's from Odor.
Hello,
readers.
Mark? Oh, all right. I will, right away. Just put your shoes on.
His feet all swolled up.
Well, I think this is fascinating. Television.
It's all swolled up, huh?
In this water.
I've been standing up a lot, and my ankles are swollen.
Is hurting, his bunions is
all. This might be serious.
Something in a green.
No. Thank you very much. All right. You're all very kind. What are you doing there?
Let me fix it.
She unties it. Let's say hello to Laura Whipple and Miriam Schuback. Applause. Hello there. Laura Whipple's the current champion, $6,800. Wow. To what do you attribute your success?
My mother.
Your mother. That's right. Without her, where would you be?
Right.
Now, listen, this game is tied 3-3, and we did one tiebreaker, and this is the second tiebreaker, and we've got to go to the third tiebreaker, don't we?
Yep.
Will you stop doing that? Okay. Well, this is the second one.
It's the second tiebreaker.
Oh, second tiebreaker right, coming up. We've only done one. Don't mix me up, ladies. You've only done one tiebreaker. Oh, I know what mixed me up. First game ended in a tie. Then we went to tiebreaker. That ended in a tie. And now we go to another game, and that's not going to end in a tie. Please roll. Tie your shoes yourself. Here we go. Oh, one tie-breaking question for each. I hate to repeat myself, but I must turn off these lights. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Miriam, again, A or B?
A.
You've been A all the way, haven't you?
A is a very
you?
Important
haven't deviated
letter to
one
me.
Bit. Tiny Tom Thumb is so short.
How short is he?
Thank you. He needs a blank to get into his shoes. What do you say, little girl?
I don't know anything about short people.
You don't? Would you stand up for a second?
Woo!
This lady is not only beautiful, she's tall and beautiful.
That's very good.
Yes.
You're not only tall, you're not beautiful.
I think
nature
beautiful.
Has a way of yeah. balancing out.
He needs a blank to get into his shoes.
Because he's so short, Barbara.
He's short. He needs a blank to get into his shoes. All right, Miriam Schuback. Tiny Tom Thumb is so short, he needs a blank to get into his shoes.
A ladder.
A ladder. You don't like that? I don't know. Sounded okay to me.
Well, little Tom Thumb is just a little short. He's just so short, he needs a ladder to get into his shoes.
A ladder to get into his shoes. Oh, Miriam's got one. Yes.
He's such a little person. He has a little voice like this, so he needs a little ladder to get into.
Small ladder.
Hello, little boy.
You know, it's a shame, as I said before, that Patty Duke isn't here when the acting is so stunning.
Yes.
Someone like that could learn so much from the things we've just heard.
Step ladder there. Another one. Tom Thumb is so short, he needs a ladder to get into his shoes, according to her and them.
I wonder what they were thinking of.
Oh, come
I don't
on,
know.
Barbara.
Step ladder. Yes. That's not a bad question. It's a fair question. Those of you who were groaning when she said ladder, what did you have in mind?
Oh! No.
What?
A spoon.
A spoon?
Ooh.
Two drunks in the audience said spoon. He's so short he needs a spoon to get into his shoes.
Baby.
Really? Okay.
Shoehorn.
I must say how nice it is to see Laurel and Hardy back on television.
They were so good. They were good in Michigan.
Right, there it is, for the Miriam.
Do what you did just did to me.
Do I have an understudy? Do I?
Yes.
I do?
Yes.
I'm in trouble. I said pole vault.
A pole vault? He pole vaulted into his shoes.
Let me finish out the week. Let me finish out the week.
Okay.
Well, she didn't do bad with hers, Laura. Now let's see how you do with yours. She's got five, means you can tie it with five again or win it with six. Did you hear?
The phone's ringing.
Yeah.
And we're on network television. And phone
did, did someone pick it up? Is it for me?
No, it's for your shoe.
It's for the shoe? Who's on the phone? I want to know who's calling in the middle of a show. Now, I want to know. Find out who's calling.
It's your doctor.
No, it's not my doctor. Who? It's your mother? His mother. What's his name? Skip. You're not Skip? No, you're not in trouble, Skip. He'll be fired tomorrow. But you're okay, Skip. Okay, here it is. Did you hear that King Kong went to Czechoslovakia and he got arrested? He tried to blank a check. King Kong went to Czechoslovakia and got arrested. He tried to blank a check.
Tried to what?
King Kong went to Czechoslovakia.
Okay. Did you hear that King Kong went to Czechoslovakia and got arrested? What is the operative word?
He went to Czechoslovakia and got arrested. He tried to blank a check.
Oh!
She sprained her wrist, so her brain is malfunctioning.
Gene, can we all sign her cast? Let's all sign
her cast. Let's all sign her cast. No, it's really not a signable cast. It's just a flexible bandage.
Sign of the
and
rail.
It would be gooey all over there. Okay, Laura Whipple, here it is. Did you hear that King Kong went to Czechoslovakia and got arrested? He tried to blank a check.
Steal?
Well, what we had in mind here was a little play on words, you see.
Yes, I know.
It's spelled C-Z-E-C-H. However, we'll say goodbye to you. Let's all say goodbye to Laura Whipple now. Goodbye. Yes. Okay.
Don't feel too bad, Laura. I had trouble with this, too.
You did.
Well, King Kong could grab people and pull them and twist them and shape them so they'd look just like Johnny Cash, a chick.
Uh-huh. No, you see.
I don't know. I didn't know what
to do. Didn't anybody get the idea here?
I got it. It took a little time. You poked fun at me.
Darling, finesse.
No, wait a minute. Let me just take a peek at it before you go. All right, you got it. Go ahead.
And also, I'd like to see the answer he threw away, because when he saw what I wrote down, he stole my answer. I took a little time.
You're a sick woman, Jane.
Take pity on me, America. I'm not well.
I'll say.
Bounce.
Bounce a check. That's it. So that means Miriam Schuback wins the game. Everybody has bounce, bounce, bounce all along the line. Well, Laura, I'm glad you're leaving here with a bundle of money. $6,800 there for Laura Whipple.
Thank you.
Goodbye, my dear. Let's send a message or two for you. And come back and see how Miriam does. Okay? Here's Miriam Schuback, her first game. Now, she only has $100, but she could go over $5,000 with a little bit of luck and skill. You ready, Miriam?
I sure am.
We polled a studio audience here not too long ago, and we said you write down your best answer to this. Blank pleasure. Now, if you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. If you match their second most frequently given response, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities will give you some good advice here.
Charles?
It's a pleasure.
It's a pleasure is one.
Richard?
It's my pleasure.
My pleasure.
Yeah. Fanny?
What's your pleasure?
What's your pleasure?
Well, those are
three. And you have an option at this point of choosing one of those three, Miriam, or giving us one of your own. What is your pleasure.
It's a pleasure.
It's a pleasure. All right. Now you look over here, Miriam, and we'll continue. We'll go down to the bottom there and reveal the $100 response. What's your pleasure is one response. It's a pleasure is what she's looking for. May we see the next one, please? Double your pleasure. No commercials, please. Not unless they pay the bill here. All right, here's the last chance for It's a Pleasure. Slide it. My pleasure.
It's my pleasure.
That really surprises me. I thought it's a pleasure to be up there somewhere. It's a well-known phrase. Too bad about that. Well, Miriam, you're going to meet another player right now. You ready?
Sure.
All right, let's welcome Gary Knight. Here he comes. Well, there they are together. Now, Gary, we'd like to welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would, please.
Right now, I'm the most nervous marriage counselor.
Really?
I'm this nervous. And,
are you nervous?
Since, yeah.
Your hands are cold.
Yeah.
You're not sweating.
I give massage, too. Can you believe it?
Yeah. You gave him a massage?
I give massage.
Oh, you do?
Yes, I give massage. And,
really?
And
rub my back a little while you're talking to me. Tell me about your life. Yeah, go ahead. Tell me about your life. Go ahead.
Well, I'm out here. I'm going to go back to school.
Yeah.
To become a child counselor.
Oh. Yeah.
I come from a town called Shadyside, Ohio, which some of you may not know is the home of America's first woman county sheriff.
Wow. Isn't that fascinating? First woman county sheriff. I don't have any money to pay for the massage, but it really felt good. He's very good. He has powerful hands. Now, you do that and you do marriage counseling. You make a living out of both of those.
Right.
Yeah. Are you married?
No, everybody asks me that. Those who can't teach.
Those who
can't teach. And those who can't teach, teach Jim, right?
An old saying in the world, those who do can and those who can't teach.
And those who can't teach.
And I asked him if he was married. He's a marriage counselor, you see, and he's responded with that. Charles, will you pay attention to what's going on this stage?
First of all, those that teach, I don't buy that, because sometimes people teach because they love to do that more than anything. And I hate that phrase.
You're in my line.
We're trying to inject a moment of levity here, Charles. You're getting too serious.
Massage.
Don't take it so seriously.
Right. Gary? Good luck to you, sir. You may have A or B.
I'll go with B.
B? Okay. Frank said, I just saw a mirage. I thought it was a camel, but...
Say no more.
But it was only blank lying on her back. Oh, you rascal. I thought it was a camel, but it was only blank lying on her back.
A camel? Well, who looks like a camel?
Now, you don't understand here. Don't talk aloud. You really don't understand this question, do you?
Those that do can. Those who can't teach.
I thought I saw a camel, but it was only blank lying on her back. I don't get it.
You don't get it. Well, you must write down something.
Somebody
don't expect to match with this dodo bird on the end here. She will write an answer. It may come to her before long.
Fanny,
I thought I saw a camel. Now, is that the cigarette or the
camel? Fanny, Fanny, look at this, you see.
Is it that?
See.
Pretend. I got it.
You got it. Oh, okay.
You look like a snake.
Now she's writing. And we'll come to Gary Knight. Frank said, I just saw a mirage. I thought it was a camel, but it was only blank lying on her back.
Fanny?
You're saying Fanny Flag.
Fanny Flag.
Yeah.
I don't even have a hump.
I couldn't think of
it. Now, wait a minute. Fanny.
I don't get it.
When you lie on your back,
on my back.
Now listen to me.
I sleep on my stomach.
I know, but that is not the...
No, that's right. She does.
But when you lie...
I read about it.
You read about it?
Yes.
In one of those fan daytime television
magazines. Magazine, yes. That interview you gave.
Yeah.
Where you said you...
Yes.
You read that, didn't you,
Holmes? Yeah, right,
you said
right.
you were on your...
Now, yeah. You do understand what this game is about here.
Well, we're supposed to match. I know that.
Right. Okay. As long as you know that.
Well, what are we to do with that little girl?
I was thinking.
Yes, tell us.
My little chickadee.
Yes.
I just saw sextet. So here they are, Mae West.
Mae West. I agree with him. That's a wonderful possibility. What do you say?
What's wrong with that cute little fanny? When you've got them, you don't know how to flaunt them.
That's right.
Now, I was going to say.
Yes.
But I didn't want to hurt Fanny's feelings. So I said Fanny.
Fanny. Okay, Gary, you got one.
But I don't even have brown hair.
A dromedary has two humps.
Two?
Don't you have two?
No.
Lying on your back, you do. Don't argue with me.
I have three.
I've seen you lie on your back. Trust me, you've got two humps.
Yeah. Yes, Charles.
Ta-da!
I hope you don't feel slighted by all this, Barbara.
Oh, no. No, not at all.
Would you show us your card?
I'd be delighted. I said Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton, yeah. Okay, Richard. Yeah.
Ray Cale.
Ray Cale is another wonderful response. Now tell us what came to your little mind, little girl.
You're not going
to
believe this. I got to thinking about who might look like a camel because of those big, beautiful eyelashes and large lips, and I wrote Gina Lola Brigida.
Gina Lola Brigida. Okay, so there you are, two for him, and yours will be along later. Now this for you.
Today's consolation prizes are first, Franciscan sea sculptures dinnerware, timeless beauty and durability with the fragile look of China, six patterns in sand and white, sea sculptures by Franciscan. And a 22-piece master mechanic multi-drive socket set, complete with fitted box, exclusively from True Value Hardware Stores. And from Ventura, a jumbo wheel Pullman in dazzling jade with nylon pull strap. This energy-saving wheel-o-matic really gets you rolling. And from Menon, put your hair on a high-protein diet with Protein 21 shampoo, hairspray, and conditioner from Menon. There's more razzmatazz coming up with Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sir, John. We're ready. Okay, Miriam. You want A or B?
Oh, I get a choice?
Yeah.
I'll still take A.
You want A, okay. I'll give you A. Here it is. Did you hear that a record company is coming out with a musical version of the Nixon tapes? Oh. Yes, they're going to call it Disco Blank. Musical version of the Nixon tapes, they're going to call it Disco Blank.
I think I lost it earlier in the week. Did you hear the radio material of the musical version of the Nixon tape? They got to call it.
Remember, it's a first-round question, and anything that comes to your mind, big, do it. You did it. Right. Okay. Disco Blank.
Go ahead. I got it. You got it. Look how she copies. Get the camera. Get the camera on this woman.
I tell you what we're going to do. If you say she copied from you this time,
well, I mean, you got
we'll
evidence.
Go from Richard to you and then to her.
Okay.
That's very good. It's
Did
wonderful.
You hear that a record company is coming out with a musical version of the Nixon tapes? They're going to call it Disco Blank.
Disco Bug.
Disco Bug. Okay. What did you say, Richard?
They're going to call it Disco Crook.
All right, we'll pass over here.
No, go ahead. I wouldn't take
no,
it
no,
away
no,
from
no,
you.
No, 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 no. If you get it,
I'll try to do this with a straight face.
Yeah.
Disco Dick.
Disco Dick. Is that what you got?
So much.
You think it's a good answer?
He wrote.
Just be quiet. I love
it. In a baby blue gown that Alice wouldn't see be seen dead in. Dennis the Menace, right?
Right.
I loved his answer so much, and I couldn't think of anything, so I did say Disco Dick.
Okay. Well, at least you're honest about it. Okay, Barbara, what have you got there?
Well, you see that I'm sitting down here, so I have nothing to do with what's going on.
That's
up there.
True.
Do you remember that song, Disco Duck?
Yes.
Disco Dick.
Disco Dick. All right. All right, Richard. Disco Bug is what she said.
I think this might be a match. Disco Gap.
Disco Gap.
Not quite. Nuts.
too bad. Too bad. Yeah. What do you got there, Fanny?
Huh?
Huh? Come on now.
Pecan and cashew and almonds. I have Disco Hum.
Disco Hum. So there we are. 2-0 the score. And now we've got this message for you. Pay attention. We have to quit right now. Here we are at the end of round one. 2-0 score. Favor the challenger. And we'll look forward to seeing all of you next time. And we'll look forward to seeing you next time, too.
Are
we
you
all
sure?
will show up, won't we?
Yeah.
All right.
We're here.
Look forward to seeing you. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 78. Goodbye, all.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.